I think the main thing is down throw gives you more like frame, gives you more frames to work with at low percent, and up throw gives you less frames to work with usually, or until the higher percent. But up throw gives you more time to like set up. See, like here, how all the setup time I have. Down throw gives you like less setup time, basically. So like, basically up throw gives you like a longer amount of time to react, or a longer amount of time to react and set up. So sometimes that's easier, I would say. But at really low percent, if you down throw, if you up throw at like zero, you technically can get in place usually. But if they do like, it's really tight to get fully set up in place at zero with up throw a lot of times for a tech chase. So it's better to usually down throw. So you have like, is it more time to set up like that? Oh. With down, yeah, down throw you can get extra pummels. Yeah, you can buffer the throw so that it basically never misses if you do it right with down throw, but with up throw, you can't buffer it, so you gotta be very careful when you pummel. If it's an opponent that likes to mash out, you gotta be extremely careful when pummeling, or just not pummel off up throw. But with down throw, you can pretty much always get like one pummel. I'm not sure at zero, but you know, it's always safer to do a pummel with down throw, at the very least. What in the mother fudge? It was just like a freaking, like I rewinded a YouTube video.
Yeah, it's rewind time.
Okay, so the reason we're stuttering, he says his sister's using Netflix in 4K quality. That's why we're teleporting. The classic. On her 720p monitor? Yeah, I'm just thinking. I mean, they might have a 4K TV. Gamers don't really care about 4K, but maybe, like, TV watchers do. What in the motherfucker? Dude, it showed he died for a frame. Is that just me? Like, showed he died, and then, like, for, like, a split, for, like, a frame, it showed, like, the blast from the blast zone, and then he just came back to life in a bead. Woo! Ho! No! Okay. Nope. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's to... Just because I play a character in one game doesn't mean I want to play them in every game. Can you imagine? Like, there's 5 Smash games. Imagine if I just was like, oh, I want to play Falcon all 5 games. That'd be funny, but that's not as, like... I feel like it makes a lot more sense to think in your brain, okay, it's a new game, it's a new opportunity to play somebody new. I think it's a lot more fun to play a new character each game than play the same thing over and over. But yeah, also, like... There's, like, no reason for me to ever play Falcon in this game. Like, he's not even considered, like, a top tier, like, super good character. Like, he's not bad, but he's not, like, worth playing. He's not good enough to warrant playing. The only way I'd consider it worth playing him if he was, like, legit, like, one of the best characters, like, really broken, and or, like, the best character. That's the only reason to, like, consider it. But even then, I would try and avoid that. He's fun. He is fun. That's true. Doesn't mean I mean, I could play him once in a while, but I'm not gonna like take him serious. But he is fun. I agree. Okay, I did not think it was gonna send that way. How does that work? Which way does it send, QQ? Is it down here? I guess. Ooh, what if I like 2-frame from that? That'd be cool. Dude. Do you see that? I just did like an aerial interrupt. How's that happening, man? Can you clip it? Is that common knowledge? Like, I'm literally just aerial interrupting. Ooh! What? Oh, gosh. What? Why does no one do that if it's so easy? I'm so confused. Alright, thank you. I'll have to check it after the stream, probably. Oh, man. Forgot the other thing. That is freaking nuts. Oh my, dude, I... Woo! Dude, that shit looked like a fucking... Melee-sus-sus. That shit looked like a melee slide-off. Like an AST. Oh my god, what in the mother fudge? No! Ah! No! No! Thank you.